Welcome to House of Horrors number 19. I'm Sherman, and this is actually the first time I post this on YouTube. Yeah, if any of you guys are interested in asking me a question, go to CAW Mainstream to ask me those questions. But there's going to be under some rules, some ground rules. But yeah, but you know, I only have 3 people for tonight's show or audio show. And we're going to start things off in ABC order. First off is Barney Green's question. His question is, what are your thoughts on GWF's current direction? You know, I like where GWF is going. You know, I like how you're using, you know, you're going old school. I like it. I actually like it. Old school, still cool, dude. I like how you went with classic Ric Flair. You bring in the classic Four Horsemen, you know, now the Four Horsemen and, you know, all this other cool stuff. You know, it's, you know, I can't wait to see more of GWF. That's all I can say. Well, that's Barney Green's question. Moving on to Rated RK's question, and that is your thoughts on VWA, Road to Inception. I'm assuming that Road to Inception is an audio show, isn't it? If it's the audio show, I have to say, I really like it. I really like your audio show. Very good, very relaxing. You sound calm. You know, you sound awesome. I can't wait to see BWA starting. I can't wait to see BWA. I am definitely looking forward to for that. BWA is gonna look so cool. That's Rated RK's question. Moving on to Extreme Tony's questions. Yeah. First question is, thoughts on Global Warning? Very good. Very good on Super Show or Joint CPV. Yeah. It's very good, actually. Second question, which tag team should dissolve in XCWL? Well, other than me and Slash dissolving, I really don't see a tag team being dissolved in XCWL. I'm out of ideas. And, three, who should form a tag team in XCWL? Sorry, I was a little hesitant, but yeah. Who should form a team? You know, I would actually like to see Trey Steele and I would like to see Trey Steele and Apollo working out as a tag team. I actually think that it could be possible, but, you know, well, there's Apollo and, well, yeah, you know, Apollo and Trey Steele, they would be an interesting tag team. You know, if singles division doesn't work, if singles competition doesn't work out for them, try the tag team. 4, should the Crucero title return? I think it should, to be honest. I think it should, because I would actually, you know, make Pac Wright defend that title against 4 of the Cruceros. You know, I do want to see the Crucero title return, but that's you. But it's up to you, dude. It's not up to me. Because I would love to see the Crucero title back and, you know, see new people holding the Crucero title, you know? 5. That's on ROH to possibly be on network television this fall. Not sure if it'll happen, but would it be nice if it did? Yeah, I mean, I would actually watch it. I wouldn't mind watching it as long as it doesn't turn out like either TNA or WWE. Then I'm cool with it, you know? 6. Better fitted to be a play-by-play or color commentator. And here's first selection, Baxter Helms. Well, he could do both. Hector Diaz. Same, he could do both as well, but he's more of a play-by-play person. Joel Knight. Well, he is a good play-by-play person. I kind of want to see him more into color commentary. He is getting there with color commentary. I could see it right there. next option, Dan Factor, who I'm going to kick his ass and make him quit like a little bitch at WrestleFest 6, and take his Central American champion and make to prove to him that he's a jokester, a joke champion that he is. Yeah, he could do both, play-by-play and color commentary. Yeah, but I kind of want to see him as a color commentator. I'm kind of curious. Another person, Eddie Mack. He is good at play-by-play. Kind of want to see him in color commentary. And the last person is Donnie Mick, play-by-play or commentator. He can do both, you know. Any other commentators? Well, they can actually, it depends on what they prefer as. They're pretty good, you know. 7. Who in the 2011 CAW draft do you think will make the most impact? I really don't know. You know, it's still, I don't know. I think everyone has a chance. Everyone has a chance to make an impact. 8. Who will be the best draft sleeper? Some drafted in second round or later. That's a very interesting question. I would have to say, this is going to sound biased. I would have to say Juan Nando Lo Chihuahua Guerrero. Because he is a spade, in other words, a cruiserweight in ACW. And I think he's going to kick some serious ass. That's all I can say. 9. Who will be a draft bust? Some drafted in the first round who may not do well. I don't think anyone will bust. I think they're going to do fine. They're just going to do fine. 10. Which CAW league had the best draft this year? I don't know, actually. All of them had a good draft. Best draft this year. So, even. No one has the upper hand. 11. How is Doug Life stacking up? Ho, I'm looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to making / the weakest link. That's all I'm going to say. I'm not going to go into any detail. And I hope to see what will happen with the XCW Ultimate Champion. And I hope that you find the person that's responsible for costing you your match at Global Warning. Yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing who is the perpetrator. Yeah, that's about it. And as for ACW news, I'm still working on WrestleFest 6, so it's gonna take me a while to record everything, get them all, edit shit, and all that shit. So yeah, thank you for listening. I'm Sherman. Yeah, and we'll see you next time.